Good morning, July 31st, the final day of July. It is Tuesday. Working on Spell Venture Game Dev. Alright. Got some extra followers from last night's stream on The Witness. Pretty cool, pretty fun. Let me see here. I'm just gonna do kind of a short one today. Kind of getting up a little bit late, but you know, it's not a huge deal. Oh my god. There we go. Okay, so I think. Good, all sounds are on, we're good to go. Okay. Let's see, what are we working on? We're working on the Skyhammer Tunnel the other morning. Yesterday morning. So in this, I was working on a Skyhammer thing. I could do it later on this week. What was I doing here? No, let's continue. We only have 30 minutes, so might as well just do something quick, right? Alright, so this is what I was working on yesterday. Just a quick D&D thing. Let's see. Alright, so the camera gives me a path. Just a little bit of rubble, huh? A little bit of rubble. There we go. So we have some of this rubble here. It's gonna be overlapping. Just like that. And we just need a little bit of rubble. This, we can smooth them out. And Again, just a quick 30-minute stream this morning before I head off to my day job. The week's been kind of crazy, so I've just been... The weekend's been really nuts. Got in from the beach from Sea Isle in New Jersey. That was just... It was fun, but very just... And, very tiring, you know. Okay, so we have these. Go ahead and join those, these as well. Join these. Okay, we're gonna move these to layer two. We are going to then go ahead and I guess it really doesn't matter, huh? Let's just go ahead and mark that seam. Mark that seam, and then so I'll mark a bunch of seams here. Mark that seam. Got another one here. We do. Okay. So that's that, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, that's fine. And then, you. Okay, so we're just marking seams here. That's all we really need. We just need enough. Let's go save Skyhammer Tunnel. Bam. I guess we could probably put them on the same one, huh? Yeah, we could do that. Straight up, join them. Separated by loose parts, geometry, join those three, join these four, okay, then we'll save, right, because we had to do this, okay, cool, 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 and then, boop, we're going to export, get export from here, so we're running a 3D cursor, export as an FBX. We want D&D blend files. FBXs. Mobile.fbx. We want to do make sure it's the substance spinner preset and we export an MPX. Alright. Geometry for each. Make sure we save again. Alright, so we have that open. Go to models. Skyhammer Tunnel. We're going to show and explore. Cool. And then we're going to go to D&D. Blend file. Skyhammer Tunnel. Copy. And then go and repaste. Alright, that's going to load. We're going to bring up Substance Painter. Hey guys, Matt Mon Gaming and Slow Cool, welcome to the stream. It's going to be like another 25 minutes or so. I don't know about only, I'm kind of burning through here. I'm working on some Dungeons & Dragons Roll 20 tile work here. There we go. Whoop, okay. I don't want that one. I want to go new. Go ahead and select. Well, I might actually need those rocks. Let me reopen real quick the Skyhammer Tunnel. Oh, I can take off this. Alright, so this is the Skyhammer Tunnel I was working on yesterday. What I want to do is I want to make a smart material out of these rocks. So I'm going to go to one of these walls, I guess probably the bottom one. It's pretty great. I mean, if this were part of like a 3D game, I mean, hell. Put a lot of rubble here just to hide the seam, but still, that's, I like it. I think I know what I can do differently, maybe. That's not really, just, come on. Okay. Let's close that up. Let's save a little bit of space here, okay? Smart material tunnel wall. And bam. Alright, so we created a smart material out of that. Now we're going to go back to the ground. We're going to go to tunnel wall. We're going to put it above everything else. Whoop! And it's going to overwrite. Well, it's going to, you know, it overlays everything on top of everything else. You're just going to see the rock. Yep. Let me see here. Okay. And that includes the shitty highlights. I'm going to get rid of. Highlight. We're gonna get rid of the shading. Okay. We're gonna put. Oh, no, let's put the shading back on. I think what I want to do here is I do want the shading in here, right? But I'm going to do that's overlaid the exact amount that I need it. Where's the color? Oh. Hey. Where are you? Base color is going to be black, and then I believe roughness metallic is all the way down, right? So here we go. Okay. Actually, wait, I already have this, right? So I can grab this guy. I already have shading. There we go. Okay, wait up. Why am I doing any of that? I already did this. Okay, let me save this. This is part of the Skyhammer Tunnel. What I want to do is I want to bring those rocks down on the slope. Okay, so I have rock surface rough. So I'm going to do a white mask. There it is. So what I'm doing is I'm masking out the rock surface because I want the path to take precedence down here. But I want the rock walls to kind of slope downward into the path. And then the path gets muddy and dark. Probably going into the darkness a little bit here. Right, it doesn't gotta be perfect. As a matter of fact, I think if it's perfect, it's probably a bit displeasing to the eye. It doesn't have all those beautiful little imperfections and lines that the eye likes to see in nature, right? And I'm gonna do the same thing for this really bright color that you see, right? So we can fill layer here, same thing, white mask. Sometimes you just gotta get down nitty gritty, you know what I mean? Final one. This should let me cut straight, yep, straight to what we need. Okay, so we have those, let me see here. Okay, I'm gonna go back to this. I'm going to hit you up with the color here. Okay, we're gonna bring this back in just a tad. Overlapping just a bit, right? Right, and this is on the texture, this is not on the topology. Right, so if I would have brought the topology down, you still have that like jagged straight line, which I don't want. I want a nice, even rock wall that's separating the two. Let's make sure, okay, let's bring it in just a bit. Chugging along just a little bit. It really sucks. What do I have going? Yeah, I've got a couple of things running. Okay. that wall now. Okay, so the wall is extending a bit down to the ground here. A little bit better, not too completely terrible. All right, and then we have the rock tracks. All right, those are top, mid, bottom. We've got mid going on here. Oh, right, this is mid. To it. There we go. There it is. That's a quite a bit better. Okay, so I'm going to take off the entire tunnel wall. Take off tracks and mains. Okay, I'm just masking out these rocks because they are dipping in quite a bit to what I need. Okay, back. Okay, and then if I bring that back, should look like they extend a bit more. Yeah, okay, cool. Send a bit further into the path. Alright, that's quite a bit better. So now, okay, I filled that. Okay. Is the only one that really needs extended out here. Some rocks, boxes, things like that. But first, I'm going to export these textures. We only need the ground texture. Where are we? DFX. effects and textures. Okay. Flash plus transparent. Bam. Go ahead and export these. Save one more time. Okay, and then we'll go into here. Materials, textures, right? Good D&D. Silver again. We'll grab these, bring them in. Okay, we'll go back to materials. We have ground right here. Textures is going to be bam. Better. I mean, you can still see that solid line there. That'll just be, this is just teaching me how I would like better model the pieces, I guess. So just, I just need a lot more detail in the model itself, a lot more individuality. Those lights and turn on the directional light. Right, cool. So we have those. Alright, Skyhammer, that's good. Now we're gonna do real quick, it's 821. Gotta say project. New, select, rubble. So if we bring this in, it's gonna give me two pieces of rubble, which is great. We're gonna go ahead and bake mesh maps. Big on the mesh maps. So now it's going to put this entire, put all 7 of these stones on one texture map, which is super efficient for us. It's really all we need. Okay, and then once it finishes that, we'll save it. Okay, and then we're going to use a tunnel wall material that we made, the smart material. Okay, we basically just put on top. It'll follow the curvature, it'll do what it's got to do. Alright, great. Oh, and we can take off. Highlights and shading. Highlights on here, just enough to see, you know, a little highlights, where's the other one? Shading, same dealio. Okay, and then we'll just shift the bars. The ambient occlusion should take care of this, but. So I'm not sure. Cool. See what I'm doing here? Just putting a little bit of shading on there, just so it, you know, just so it pops a little bit more, you know? It's insane. There we go. We can move them around however we want when we're finally back in the Unity scene. Alright, cool. Alright, export resources. Whoops. Make sure we save as well. 826. Okay, it took me 5 minutes. I'm going to export textures into the texture D&D FBX's textures. Bam, right there. It's going to be 2048. Dilation, transparent. Bam, go ahead and export them. Alright, and that's going to be the end of this morning. So thank you so much for joining. It was a, you know, it was a brief one. Tomorrow morning I'll be on for the full hour. 7:30 to, that's 7:20 to 8:20. That'll be Wednesday, and then tomorrow night I'm going to be doing the Witness stream again. I did it last night as well. So if you follow the YouTube video, the YouTube link right below the video here, you can go and you can find the Witness playlist. And I play, I'm playing through the Witness every Monday and Wednesday night, 9 p.m. to 11. Alright, so have a very great day. Have a very great Tuesday. And I will see you when I see you. Bye.